Hi everyone, welcome to the RP President's Commission. Now we are discussed about Telegram doubt session lecture number 2. TDS lecture number 2. Okay, in this lecture we are discussed about one of the CSIR problem which are given in the 2016 December for 4 marker. Very easier question. So which is regarding to the biomolecules, carbohydrate question. Okay, so in this question they are given the one question with several reagents. They are given the 4 options, among the 4 which is correct. Okay, without the concept we didn't touch these type of questions. So first of all, what we need to solve these questions now here. So we know that the concept of chair conformation of cyclohexane. So in generally chair conformation of cyclohexane like this. So this is this chair conformation. So both are the chair conformation, doesn't matter. So now here it is the first position. So the chair position having the 2 hydrogens. So CH2, that indicates here it is the 2 hydrogens are present. So these 2 hydrogens orientation is different. So one is 90 degrees. Now these 90 degrees are oriented like this. One is upward direction, another one is downward, upward, downward, upward, downward. So these are the 90 degrees rotations. So here it is minus 90, here it is plus 90 degrees orientation. So here one position of the one carbon atom. Now the second position, which is closer to the equatorial, okay, it is equatorial. That means here, so here if it is plus 19, here it is minus 19 degrees, minus 19 degrees. Here it is minus 19, will the plus 19 degrees, plus 19 degrees. Generally, plus or minus 19 degrees positions are called axial positions. Plus or minus 19 degrees positions are called equatorial positions. Equatorial positions. So now here it is the equatorial. Now here the axial position is upward, then equatorial is downward. Equatorial is downward, axial is upward. Axial is upward, equatorial is downward. Now here axial is downward, equatorial is upward. This is the axial and equatorial positions of a cyclohexane. So in this office, in these type of cyclohexanes are cyclohexane epoxides, these type of complexes. So in generally, or not only these, so any type of complexes. So based on the steric crowding as well as chelating effects are present. Okay, in generally, in these type of epoxides opening reactions or any nucleophilic attack reactions of cyclohexane compounds, axial attack is preferred. Axial attack is preferred. So here only axial attack is preferred over than the equatorial attack in case of cyclic epoxide chemistry. This is the basic knowledge about cyclohexane chemistry, cyclohexane chain conformation formula. Now let us go through our problem. So now here they are given in the acylated carbohydrate moiety. So first of all, they are given in the PBr3. So here phosphorus, bromine. According to the electronegativity, bromine is more electronegative than phosphorus. That means phosphorus is electrophile, bromine is a nucleophile. That means here PBr3 will give the Br-. That means Br, bromide nucleophile. That gives bromide nucleophile. Now in this case, first of all, this is the product. This is the reactant. Okay. Now here it is OAC. Here OAC. OAC. Here OAC, OAC. So according to our previous discussion, here equatorial attack is not preferred. Why? Because if it is possible, it is the glycosidic bond. It is a glycosidic bond. So glycosidic bonds are readily reactive over than the other positions. So now here, it is the glycosidic bond. These glycosidic bond bottom axial position having the OACyl group. So, however, the nucleophile, maybe it is transferred this group with the equatorial attack, that is the possibility. So, now here, oxygen having the lone pair of electrons, whenever our nucleophile having the several lone pairs, this is the nucleophile. Okay, so whenever the nucleophile comes towards the equatorial position, so these lone pair electrons, again, nucleophile lone pair electrons repel to each other. Due to the electronic repulsion, the nucleophilic attack at equatorial position is blocked. So our nucleophile cannot attack over the equatorial position. So that's why, so instead of nucleophilic attack, our oxygen lone pairs creates the electrophilic center of adjacent position. Now here our oxygen lone pairs will shift towards the carbon oxygen single bond, that is glycosidic carbon atom. Now here it is eliminated. So here it requires 180 degrees periplanar. Here our lone pairs will fulfill the elimination product. Now it will give us OAC, OAC, OAC. Now here it is OAC. So here it is eliminated. So whenever the oxygen valency is 2, now here the more valency of oxygen, it presents a plus. Now here our Br minus will attack at the either equatorial position or axial position. Now here equatorial position is blocked due to the formation of a pi bond. So here the pi bonded electrons it fills the equatorial position. That's why our nucleophile attack over the axial position only. Now here bromide ion attack at axial position. Now it becomes neutral. Okay. Now here OAC, OAC, OAC. OAC, like here it is the OAC, here it is like a bromide, it is a bromide. So now after that, this is the over of the our first reagent. Okay, first reagent role is over. Now in the second case, they are given in the reducing agent, zinc in acetic acid. Here it helps to eliminate the our bromine moiety with OAC. That means here it forms the nucleophile. This bond zinc atom will abstract the bromide ion. Now bromine electrophile only, not the ion. So these bonded two electron will shift towards the adjacent bond. Now here it creates a double bond. Then it is elimination takes place. Then it is eliminated. Okay, now here OAC, OAC, OAC. Okay, now here it creates the double bond. Okay, and now after the formation of double bond, they are given in the NIS. So NIS means NBS, NBR. Okay, NBS means N-bromosuccinamide. Now here NI means N-iodosuccinamide. N-iodosuccinamide. Here it donates the iodine electrophile. So whenever the alkene, which is treated with electrophile of a halogen, now it forms the halonium ion. Now in this case, here also it forms the halonium ion with above the plane chemistry. Okay, now here it is the double bond. Here it creates the iodonium ion. OAC, OAC, OAC. Okay, so here it is the iodonium ion. So after that, they are given in the one nucleophile, that is methanol. So that methanol will attack over the axial position. Why? Because here equatorial position is blocked. Here only the axial position is preferential attack. So here the equatorial position of second position and third position are blocked. That's why here the axial attack is favored. Then our methanol will attack over the axial position. Then it becomes I neutral. So here it is the I plus. Whenever the bonded two electron will shift it towards the iodine atom, then it gets a negative charge. Negative, positive will becomes a neutral. Now we will get the final product. Okay, here OAC, OAC, OAC. So here it is iodine, here it is O-methanol. This is the final product. Okay, so in general here the main key role of the position is a glycosidic bond. So here only it reacts. So instead of here the lone pair repulsion, due to the lone pair repulsion, here equatorial attack is not possible. That's why it will happen, it forms the double bond over the carbon oxygen. Okay, then after our nucleophile attack over there, then presence of a reducing reagent, it forms the double bond. Then after iodine electrophile will create the halonium ion, that is iodonium ion, then followed by the nucleophilic attack of axial position, it gives the final product. So according to our options, now here iodine is top of the position. This is not right. Again, second the B option, so it retains their positions. Okay, so B is correct. So every position is changed. Now here in the case of C, iodine over there, that means here the formation of iodine with the bottom plane. So bottom plane electrophile, it is not possible whenever these forms the cyclic conformation. If it is possible, I'll make the video on cyclohexene conformations with a straight chain formation. Like this type of conformational videos. If it is possible, I'll make that video. Okay, so now here D. So D also wrong option. Now according to our concept with the reagents, option number B is correct. Correct. So this is the very small video regarding to the CSIR problem on Telegram doubt session, lecture number 2. Okay. Thank you for watching.